Hello, buddy. I want to do a quick update and post this in a few minutes. There's a few news things that I've not been commenting on because I don't want to do too many, just news updates. But there's a few. Just now, as I was watching the news, I think you saw this already. If not, you'll see that on tomorrow's video. I got a little, I don't even remember if it's up yet or not. I'm watching the news. Tonight, American fighter planes have been bombing again, just new bombings in Libya. And the way the news reported it, Channel 3, it said, we're bombing, I think it's a particular area in Libya, but it's new. It's new bombing. And Channel 3 news, media bias is what upsets me. I'm not a big fan of Trump, but when I see all of the bias, that's why you hear me talk about that. And as the news reported it, it said, the request was made by the leadership of Libya, and it was approved by President Obama. Instead of asking the question, since when do foreign countries request our military to go into action in another country, and that the President of the United States approves that? It's a violation of the Constitution, which says whenever we engage in military action, Congress has to approve that. And I'm mad because the media has made it sound so, because of their bias, they should have reported the fact that it's highly questionable that any foreign country could make any request for us to bomb anybody in that country. And the way they're doing it is under the old order that we're going to hit terrorists wherever they're at. I'm not against hitting ISIS, whether it's Libya or... but you have to do it the proper way. Also, just today, I read a Russian helicopter, I believe, aid helicopter. What they're doing in Aleppo in Syria, they're probably strengthening, like which I said in some of the other videos, but it was shot down by, quote, rebels. These are people, now this is the second Russian aircraft shot down. The other one was by Turkey, who Turkey, forget it, Turkey tonight is also the leader, Erdogan, who you know I do not support. They're going back on their deal. They want free access to all the European countries. They're part of NATO, which is a huge mistake. But now they're saying if you don't open up the access for Turkey residents to go anywhere freely in the other European nations, then they're going to go back on their promise that said they were going to take all the refugees. The other news thing that I've not been mentioning, the Democratic National Convention, you had the very nice Muslim father whose son was also Muslim who died as an American soldier defending the country. All right, now the Democrats are using this man in a bad way in the sense that his son died. And the man obviously is upset. And he says, has Trump read the Constitution or not? What Mr. Trump, or anybody that's president, when they're talking about immigration, whether you agree with Trump or not, when you're talking about immigration from a foreign country to the U.S., we actually have laws in place. And our Constitution doesn't guarantee protections for non-citizens. Look, we have... So they're manipulating this Muslim man, who is a good man, whose son was also Muslim, who died fighting for this country. But what that man should really question is, why did the son actually die? why was that entire war that your son died in, and others that our sons and daughters have died in, why are we in them? We were in them because of not only George Bush's disastrous decisions to use false, which was later showed out to be false, intelligence that Saddam Hussein had. The whole question should be, why did your son die? And the Democrats had this man on stage and going on to all the things. You have a direct, the other person running for office that you stood on that woman's convention, she had a direct result of the death of her son by the votes that she made when she was a senator, voting for these wars. The woman, Hillary Clinton, the Republicans had one of the mothers of the people who died in Benghazi, who Hillary Clinton had a direct role in their death. You say, why? Because the fact is, though the Ambassador Stevens who died in Benghazi, Libya, as well as the others who died, they were requesting and saying to the State Department, we're all going to get killed over here unless you beef up the security. We're being scoped out. And the reason they did not do it, the reason Hillary Clinton and the State Department did not beef up security in Benghazi was for political reasons. For political reasons. And they made many requests. Some reports were, 1,000 requests were made. Others say about 600. Meaning they were saying, so say if that Muslim man who the Democrats are using to their advantage, say if that Muslim man, actually Trump himself was in charge of the State Department, and say if that Muslim man's son made requests, he was out in the battlefield, and he said, Mr. Trump, can you please send me backup? And say if Mr. Trump was directly involved for political reasons to not send backup to that man's son. That's exactly what happened with the victim of the Benghazi attack. And one of the mothers spoke at the Republican National Convention, rightly outraged, because her son's death was a direct action from Mrs. Clinton. And MSNBC and a few other organizations almost mocked that mother of the son who was killed. Regardless of you, if you're a Trump or Hillary, it's manipulation. It's manipulation. I just read an article also in the Corpus Caller. I'll comment real quick on the Freddie Gray death. The black kid who died in the custody of the police in Baltimore. Famous case. Now, I understand, when I commented on this case in the past, the prosecutor, Mosley, a black woman, they said it was political. But as I looked at that case, I was not against the officers in the sense that it was... The problem in that case was, obviously, Freddie Gray's neck was broken. And like the prosecutor who now dropped charges, he said he didn't kill himself. But as the cases went to trial, it seems as if they were saying it was from neglect and so forth, which is, obviously is hard to prove. But even at, when Freddie Gray was arrested, it looked like his back was broken on the video that we had when they were dragging him to that van, that police van. That, but remember this, those of you that almost rejoice that those, remember that that kid died, and he didn't die in a normal way. When he was in the back, look, I was in EMT for 25 years. When you have a head injury, you have a sense of impending doom. You begin feeling like you're going to die. And they teach you in paramedic and EMT school that if a victim, a patient, says, I think I'm going to die, pay attention to their words. It's a very fearful thing when they realize that. And victims of neck, head injuries, when they start talking like that, and that's what Freddie Gray was saying, if I remember, that's tragic what happened there. Okay, that's tragic. These are all issues that we're dealing with right now. I was upset just watching the news a minute ago because it basically said that thing about Libya made the request and the president approved it. In Channel 3 News, it's because they're so biased. The question should be, are we violating the Constitution, which basically says Congress has the authority to vote on war? Or are we in a time now where whether it is a liberal president or a conservative president, where they can basically honor the requests of foreign countries for our military to engage? That's problematic. I don't care if you're liberal, I don't care if you're conservative. That's problematic. Bush, even though I disagree with his war, Congress approved that. A lot of people don't realize that. They voted on the Iraq war. So before we go hopping around all over the world, because it's our guys that are there. It's our guys that are there. And to that Muslim fault, I understand that they manipulated that man. Because he made all the talk shows and all. And he had the Constitution. But I would say, when any president, Hillary or anybody, when anybody says we're going to be careful about a particular region of the world where immigrants might be coming from, that has nothing to do with the Constitution. Mr. Trump, he's never spoken badly about Muslim citizens who are fighting for the country. Your son died because of wars that the person that you're defending voted for. And then later when she was questioned, was it a mistake that you voted for these wars, particularly Iraq? She said, no, it wasn't a mistake. But now recently, shit, it was. Of course it was a mistake. The untold amount of people that were killed, even if the intelligence was correct on the Iraq war, which the manipulation, look, Russia had the second chopper. The other one was a plane that was shot down by Turkey. This is over Syria. And now they had 5 people killed. And the people that are shooting at those Russian choppers, these are rebels on the ground that we are supporting with military aid. I'm wondering if Russia is permitting this to happen, to build up. Because what they're doing in Aleppo, supposedly Russia is doing a humanitarian thing in Aleppo in Syria. I believe it's Aleppo, this is the region, the city. But what they're more than likely doing is clearing out the city, because what I said, Russia and Assad are going to, they've been joining forces. And the U.S. is absolutely, they must be thinking we're really lost, because John Kerry is still having discussions with Lavrov, the Russian military guy. And it's like we're in coordination. There's no coordination. Russia's going to, they have a other view of what's going on in Syria. And I believe we in the U.S. we're going to probably wind up backing out when an ultimatum is given. I've written on that. It might be in a post tomorrow or something. I wanted to do this just real time because all of these things, we have to question. I saw Julian Assange being interviewed, those who are familiar from WikiLeaks. Who's being interviewed about WikiLeaks that came out about the DNC emails? And even though he's been interviewed, they're asking him. And look, he's no conservative, Assange. He's hiding, he's holed out in the Ecuadorian embassy in Britain because the U.S. is after him because of his WikiLeaks. But as he's having the discussion with, I think it was, I forget the guy's name, but it was a Sunday talk show. They had Assange on. And they're asking him, what about, you know, and they're going after Hillary and all. And he said, look, we're revealing actual things that were taking place in the DNC and the other emails that now we found out were happening. So we're revealing corruption in your system. And you're here asking me, Julian Assange, if we are in cahoots with Russia to go after Hillary, even Assange is like, you guys got some conspiracy going on, vast right-wing conspiracy that you're unable to do anything. What we need to do at this season, at this time, is we need to judge, just look at what people are saying. I don't justify, you know, look, Trump goes off the rails, but they made so much of a story. They made this top story about this Muslim man waving the Constitution and all. Look, they're manipulating that man. His son should have never died in the war that he died. Okay? I forget exactly which theater the boy died in, but I'm just saying. And no presidential candidate is saying Muslim American citizens who are fighting are banned from the country. Every president, no matter who they are, have an immigration policy. I'm not for saying banning Muslims, but the argument that the man is making, they're manipulating that man. The article I read in the Caller Times, by the way, mentioned the Freddie Gray case, but it also said a lot, like I say, that the system, when you find wrongdoing, maybe they lied about reports, officers, and law. The system is not working, and when you try to correct it, as well-meaning as many of the officers are, the system, you automatically, if you think your career is on the line, you accidentally did something, maybe you shot somebody, the system is really not working in order to weed that out. Because if there was a shooting, God forbid, today, and look, we've had a couple more officer shootings, which are terrible. But when you have these things happen, these things occur, the immediate response is a lot of the guys write false reports, a lot of them cover. And the Caller Times agreed and said that they felt the same thing, this system. Okay, the next few days, when I'm doing a lot of old uploads and all, you're looking at some of the older videos. The next few days, we're going to do a little bit more on Samuel. And I'm covering a little bit from some of the recent readings, the Psalms, Ecclesiastes. So this is just going to be a little, just wanted to give you an update. We as the public, we need to be informed. And a lot of the media outlets are just simply not doing it. They're simply not doing it. I talked somewhat about the economy. I just read an article today. A lot of money, I thought a lot of money was coming into the market from various foreign entities. Look, China and other countries, they're selling, okay? The global picture the last few days is not good. Surprised the Dow only went down like 20-something points because they readjusted the GDP. A lot of numbers came in bad, and plus a lot of foreign countries are dumping U.S. debt. And we thought when we did that little interest rate hike for the Federal Reserve, we thought many of these countries were not going to do it. So there are some big problems. I just saw some of that in the news today. There are some big problems. And it seems as if, like I said before, people don't want to necessarily look at the Federal Reserve System. You know, it's a private bank. It's not. Before the Great Depression in our country, we did not have a central bank, Federal Reserve Bank, with the board and the way it's run our bank. But it was developed not as a bad thing, but because after the depression that we had run on the people had run on the banks, money came out, bank. Okay, so that's why that was formed. But they make decisions. Even to give money during the crisis of 2008, they made decisions to give money to other countries without Congress knowing. That's an amazing thing. It's a lot of power in the hands of a private banking system, like a banking cartel. Very amazing. But that when the interest rate went up a little bit this past year, they thought the result would be a lot of foreign countries who invest that's how we run our country on all this credit. They thought they were going to keep doing it, but they've been dumping it. They've been dumping it. So there's some things going on in that system that are also... But let's end this. Just a little update. I want to do it. The scripture says, Hebrews, everything that can be shaken will be shaken. So the things that cannot be shaken will remain. So the kingdom of God, God's kingdom is stable. But in the midst of shaking, that's where God's kingdom is. That's where you see, oh, God's glorified. David said, even if the mountains are removed, everything's falling apart. He understood that God was that mountain, okay? This is just a quick update. A few of those little things are running in the news right now. And I talk about this, I think the video goes up tomorrow. My little church. I think I might have posted it right. You see how I'm kind of behind. The Lord bless you guys and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you and give you peace. God bless.